water drops. That's the best.
You can sand on that too.
Sand?
I don't even sand on that side.
That rich the sand.
Very technical terms.
Mm-hmm. No, you got it. That's the right term. Smush. My beginnings are as a, you know, I use my facility. I can draw and paint like you would not believe.
You used to draw.
Yes, yes. As a matter of fact, DC Comics, Marvel Comics, all these guys asked me to work with them when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And I saw Jackson Pollock's work, and that was it.
Yes.
And from that point on, it's been like, you know, it was always like tying your hands, not using that part of the facility because it was sort of like this prettified surface that wasn't allowing me to sort of get, you look at Jackson Pollock's work, boom, right past that surface, you're in there. It's your visceral experience. And so when it comes to the challenges of getting past that surface, I like to accept it. So of course, when I came here, it's like, okay, what should be my jump off point, right? And so I took the photographs and I said, you know what, this is such a rigid medium, photography. What if I took this and actually began to twist it? I didn't know what was gonna be on the other side of it, but look. It's like, it's alive. And I think that that's, you know, all it takes is just, you need a base to jump off from.
Yeah.
Solid base, I do anyway. And from there, I mean, it's like I said, like my beginnings was all about that. You know, you have your facility, but what else can you do with that? What kind?
So you can sand into this, and you'll start to obliterate some of your image.
Okay. On the actual plate.
On the actual plate.
Sure. Got it.
And all right. So you'll start to lose some of this information.
Mm-hmm. That's what I'm looking for.
And it'll fade.
Beautiful. Yeah. That's the way
they. It down.
You said soap. What is it, like melted soap or ivory
soap? It's ivory soap, and we grate it.
Is that right?
And put it in a coffee grinder, get it really fine. Some linseed oil, a little bit of titanium white pigment.
Titanium white ivory soap. And that's heavy.
Yeah, so that's the hard ground.
Hard and soft. So you guys, we keep them separate, I'm saying.
They're just different temperatures, so this melts at a lower temperature.
In the studio right now, the biggest challenge for me actually is to introduce color into the work. It's something that has not happened for a long time in my work. I started off as a painter, really, and we're talking when I was in my teens. And now, you know, like at this point in my life, it's like, how do I bring that back in? And it's an interesting challenge, you know, it's like twisting again or something. discovering and like failing and then like you know, getting back up and falling back down and getting back up again. So it's like that's what's going on in the studio. So yeah. Okay, now let's run that and then from there we'll be able to meet before.
I have that okay. Get these types of ideas.
I can, but you should prep them so then I can jump into it. Do you really want to sort of like do this? Encompass yourself in this kind of like, this is what I am. I'm a painter, I'm a sculptor, I'm a photographer. No, all those, this is all about art making. You're born an artist and you're on the road to discovery. So that's it. Don't overcomplicate it. Yeah. That's why I was able to come in here and become fluid, you know? And with the help of the technicians who are magnificent, it was pretty easy.
Yeah.
That's brown.
Yeah, yeah.
And black. This is just the blue.
It's blue and black.
Black is already. Well, I'm sorry. It's okay. Got it. Okay. That's the difference. Okay. So this is the brown. This is brown and black and blue.
Yeah, this is that black and that dark gray.
I was expecting something else. When I was putting the information down, I thought we were going to get like a gradation.
Yeah,
actually, I thought we were going to get
It looked like that more, but it.
Go ahead, tell me what happened exactly.
So it's not hard to know.
So we know how to get here, but now we have to like figure out how to get it to do what we wanted to do. So you tell me.
Well, you can sand into it. That would probably be
the actual plate. Mm-hmm.
That would be the way.
I think we should
most directly to get back towards
into the actual plate.
Yeah, you can just sand
onto that. Mm-hmm.
That would probably be we're gonna have to the do best that. Way.
We're not doing it here, we're gonna have to do it there.
I don't like area. Sure, if you like that variation,
that we
it's, just it's so fine. We're just worried that it might not that, hold up.
Right.
So
we better do something to make sure it does because it's important.
We can make it more pronounced and we can do it on the plate that has the brown aquatint. Mm-hmm. So we'll just ink in two separate sections. So we'll have the blue up above, very transparent.
You know, it's amazing. I mean, okay, so what exactly did you guys do to make these things pop like this? As in, maybe it's because there's not a lot of stuff on the wall, but take some credit. What did you do?
Filing.
Is that what it is?
A lot of it was filing.
Look how sharp that is.
So and the steel facing
really,
you can wipe it much cleaner. So it's
great.
Just,
mm-hmm. I mean, this is
I'm glad you like these. I think they look great.
Yes.